If you and your friends needed help fighting a monster from another dimension, who would you ask to join you in battle? Today, we're going to break down the English and Hellfire Club's last stand against the Dungeons & Dragons evil boss named Vecna. And although our characters will eventually have to face real monsters from other worlds, our scene sets the stage for what is to come in later episodes. This video will focus on the iconic Dungeons & Dragons game, played by our heroes. And you'll want to know a little bit about this game, so I'll be here to help you with the basics. Hi, my name is Cal, and welcome to my channel, where we break down the English in some of your favorite American TV shows and movies. I happen to be a big fan of this series, and whether you've seen Stranger Things or not, I think you'll enjoy the excitement in today's lesson as much as I have. Dungeons & Dragons has been a favorite game with our characters in Stranger Things since the beginning. And the truth is, with me, I've never really played Dungeons & Dragons before. It just always seemed a little silly to me. But this episode has me a little curious about what character I'd be if I did play. You know what? I just might make a character for myself. Nonetheless, the guys in our show refer to these nights as Hellfire Club, and tomorrow night is a very important game night that requires everyone to have been playing game after game over the last semester, leading up to a final game tomorrow night. And this is going to end up with a final battle against the evil boss, Vecna. Eddie is our dungeon master. That means that he's sort of the leader of the game. He controls and organizes everything that happens with our characters. And to tell you the truth, he's not such a nice guy in this show. And Mike and Dustin have to tell Eddie that Lucas can't make it to tomorrow's big game.
Shit, he seems really revved up tonight.
He's always revved up. We'll just act casual.
Casual?
Casual.
Right. Okay. Totally.
So, speaking of monsters, Lucas has to do his, balls and laundry baskets game.
Revved up. This means to be really excited or energetic about something, and it could be positive or negative depending on the situation. Maybe you're revved up to see your favorite team play in the World Cup, or maybe you're revved up because of politics and you're so angry about some particular situation.
So, he's not gonna be able to make it to Hellfire tonight. And I know there's no way we can beat your sadistic campaign without him. So me and Mike, we were talking, and we were thinking that maybe we might postpone.
Postpone?
No. Over my dead body.
Over my dead body. This, of course, does not mean an actual dead body. It's a way of emphasizing that someone's really against something, so they say, there's no way I would allow it. For example, the only way I let someone drive my new car is over my dead body. So what they're saying here is there's no way they're going to postpone tomorrow's Hellfire Club.
We showed you that school didn't have to be the worst years of your lives, right?
No.
Okay, no. Well, I'm here to tell you that there are other little lost sheepies out there who need help. We need you. And all you guys gotta do is get your Bo Peeps on and go and find one.
Little Bo Peep. Eddie is making reference to an old child song called Little Bo Peep Has Lost Her Sheep.
Bo Peep? Woody, it's Bo Peep!
Essentially, what Eddie's saying is Mike and Dustin cannot postpone Hellfire Club. Instead, they're going to have to go out and find a sheep, someone to replace Lucas. So Mike and Dustin need to find a replacement for Lucas. The only thing is that the game of Dungeons & Dragons is a bit misunderstood with the general population, so it might be difficult finding somebody willing to play. So let's see how successful they are.
Nancy, hey, do you want to join Hellfire tonight?
Can you fight with dice?
Yes, but these aren't your normal dice. They have up to 20 sides.
20 sides? Most dice you've seen have six sides, 1 through 6. These are really common in the movies and games and casinos. But there are several types of dice in Dungeons and Dragons, and one of those is called a D20 die. Yes, die is singular and dice is plural. So in this situation, it's possible to roll any number 1 through 20. But this fact didn't really seem to interest the wrestler we just saw, so it looks like he's not going to be joining the club.
If I play, do I get one of those cool t-shirts?
Yes.
Really?
Everyone gets a t-shirt. We make them ourselves. And if you... You're being sarcastic. You're being sarcastic? Just being sarcastic.
No.
No.
No. No.
Sarcastic. Sarcastic is our adjective. Sarcasm is our noun. Sarcasm is using words that mean the opposite of what you really mean, and this is a really common way of speaking in America and the West. This could be meant to be funny, or it can be meant to be rude, depending on the situation. Max, the girl in this scene, is being sarcastic to Dustin and really doesn't want to join Hellfire Club's Dungeons and Dragons game. But Dustin gets the bright idea to ask Lucas's sister, Erica, to join in his place. The only problem with that is she isn't a high school student like everybody else. She's actually much younger. Also, making a character in Dungeons and Dragons is a little more complicated than I thought. This is a character sheet that you need to fill out, and it's not that simple to do. You need a name, a race, a class level, alignment, and a lot more. This will take a little more time than expected.
Absolutely not.
You asked for a sub, we delivered.
This is Hellfire Club, not babysitting club.
I'm 11, you long-haired freak.
My, my. The child speaks. So, what's your name, child?
Erica Sinclair.
So this is Sinclair's infamous sister.
Infamous. Infamous is defined as being well known for some bad quality or deed. Erica is known for her strong personality and opinions. She always seems to make sarcastic or rude comments when interacting with other characters, just as you're about to see.
What's your name, child?
Erica Sinclair.
So this is Sinclair's infamous sister.
He's sharp.
He's sharp. This is another great example of sarcasm used in a negative way. Being sharp means to be intelligent or being able to make quick decisions. By calling Eddie sharp in this situation, she's actually saying the opposite.
What's your class and level? Level 1 dwarf?
My name is Lady Applejack, and I'm a chaotic, good, half-elf rogue level 14. And I will sneak behind any monster you throw my way and stab them in the back with my poison-soaked kukri. And I'll smile as I watch them die a slow, agonizing death. So, we gonna do this? Or we gonna keep chit-chatting like this is your mommy's book club?
Chaotic, good, half-elf rogue level 14. Without getting into the details, we can see that Erica has a strong and experienced Dungeons & Dragons character. Her character's race is half-elf, her class is rogue, and her alignment is chaotic good. Although I'm not really familiar with that type of character, nonetheless, it impresses Eddie and the rest of the group.
Welcome to Hellfire.
Great, I've made some progress with my character. I've decided to be a half-orc, whose class is Ranger, and whose alignment is lawful good. But I'm still a little confused. And if you like this content, subscribe so you don't miss out on more. Now it's time to play. The Hellfire Club must work together against Eddie's character, the evil Vecna. And this foreshadows what will come to pass in later episodes when our characters have to face what we consider the real Vecna. But first, we have this battle to win today.
Do you flee Vecna and his cultists? Or do you stand your ground and fight? Come on.
I say we fight. To the death.
To the death.
To the death.
When you decide to fight to the death, you have to risk everything. But things don't go in their favor. They're losing the battle against Vecna.
Time out! Time out!
Guys, I hate to say this, but we've got to flee.
I concur.
Didn't we just agree to the death?
That wasn't literal. Vecna just decimated us. We can't kill him with two players.
You two? What do you think, Mike?
How many hit points do you and Applejack have left?
12.
What do you say, Lady Applejack?
You really gotta ask?
Do you really gotta ask? Or do you really have to ask? Do you really got to ask? This means it's obvious what the answer is. There's no reason to ask that question.
Chances of success are 20 to 1.
Never tell me the odds.
Never tell me the odds. I love this line, and it's a reference to a Star Wars movie called The Empire Strikes Back. This is where Han Solo plans to take their spaceship through an asteroid belt, and C-3PO tells him the odds of survival, which are not that good.
Sir, the possibility of successfully navigating an asteroid field is approximately 3,720 to 1!
Never tell me the odds.
Now it's up to Lady Applejack to roll the dice, and this will determine the final outcome of the battle against evil Vecna. Rolling a 20 is about as good as it gets. A 20 is considered a critical hit against Vecna. Vecna is defeated, and the Hellfire Club wins tonight's battle. It's sometimes said that big things come in little packages, and tonight Lucas's sister has certainly proven herself valuable to the Hellfire Club. And you know what? I've changed my mind about Dungeons and Dragons too. I think it'd be a lot of fun to play with a group of people. What about you? What do you think about the game? Let me know in the comments below. So far, it's been a lot of fun battling monsters from other dimensions, but what if you could travel to other dimensions in your dreams? Check out this video here where we check out the movie Inception so you can continue to level up your lingo.